Hello and welcome to Kimber Bushcraft. Welcome to my series Bushcraft from A to Z in random order. And today it shall be about the letter C and of course carving tools. So I brought my carving tool set with me. Actually I have three of them for different tasks. So I would like to show you these sets and the carving tools I have in them. Hope you'll find this little video interesting and perhaps be inspired to get ahead with carving yourself. And perhaps a little bit wiser what kind of carving tools that you should have. So hang on. And beside the carving tools I would like to show you in this video, I also finished my processing of the blackberry root, and actually going to be the first time I'm making it, my blackberry root bark tea. So I'm looking very much forward to that, and hope you enjoy that too. Yeah. And this is the carving tools I have for different purposes. This one, a small one, a large one, and this are for other stuff, bigger tasks that I'm going to carve in, and I use these. I'll start by telling you about my little carving tool set. It's in this pouch from Frost River, and as I said before, I always carry this in my rucksack. And it's only have two things in it. I have a little knife from Mora knife. It's very good for small carving. And this hook knife or spoon knife that you can use when you are making a kukse or making a spoon. So these two knives from Mora I always have with me if I'm out in the woods and perhaps I would like to begin carving a little thing. I have these and I can use these. I use them a lot. Most of my spoons are made with these, and my first kukse was also made with these. And I made a little sheath for both of them, and I actually made a video about how I did that. And I'll put a link below to those videos so you can see how you can make these small sheets for carving tools. And then this one, and this is the largest pouch I have for carving tools, and the pouch is from Beavercraft, and most of the tools in here is also from Beavercraft. Beavercraft is a company in Europe, and they make these carving tools in Europe. So, and it is very good quality. In here I have two spoon knives, a small one and a large one. And of course this one is good for small spoons and spoons in particular. And this one is good for when you're carving a kukse or larger spoons. You can come deeper with this one, and it's very sharp too. And then I have this. I think it's called a gouge. I can also use this when I'm carving a kukse, because I can come deep down and carve it in the bottom too. Then I have two knives. I have a large one that is good for the big task when I'm cutting a lot of woods, and a small one here for chip carving or when it's going to be fine details in my carving. It's very pointed here, and it's good to come in different places. And then I have two things that is not from Beavercraft. This little saw is actually made for when you are going to make a knife with the rat tail. Rat tail is a knife that not full tang, but it has a little pointed that you are going to put into your piece of wood or antler or what you are using. And to make this hole, you actually use this little saw so you can put it in and make a hole there so you can put your rat tail down there. So, and this is not something I have bought from Beavercraft, as I said before. But I think it's a good one to have, especially if you're going to make some cuttings that is a little bit larger than you can use with your knives. So this one, you can buy them on Amazon. I bought this in Denmark, and I think it's really a good addition for my carving tool. And then a little awl I bought on the Viking market. It's also it always good to have such one, going to punch holes and make hole in wood and leather too. And it has a little bit of handle here, and hand forge, of course. It's really old school. So these tools, primarily from Hevercraft, is something I use for most tasks. Spoon and cook sets and so on. And it's very versatile, and I love it. So, then for this, and this is actually something I have made myself, little pouch, and inside here you can see there are different things. First of all, this one from Beavercraft 2, so you can sharpen your hook knives with it. You can see there's leather on this side and sandpaper on this side, and you can use it like that. I also made a video about that, and actually do it like this too. I've never seen such a one before, and it works very good. I can keep my hook knives, my spoon knives, sharp all the time, and I can definitely recommend you to buy one of these. It can also be used for this, a gouge. This one is also from Beavercraft, and I made a little sheet for it, so I don't hurt my hands. And this one you can also sharpen using this little tool, like this. So, and this one I've used several times when I'm carving a kuxa. I also made video where I used this. It's very nice to come deep down, and you can cut a lot of material away very quickly. So this one I can also recommend you if you are going to make a kuxa. And in here I think there's a compound for this little scrub. Yeah, and this is a crook knife. It's called from a company called Diao, I think it's Swedish, and it's actually a pull knife. You hold like this and you pull it to yourself, and of course it has a crook here, so you can also use it for making kuxas and so on. It's really an awesome piece of gear. I made the handle myself. You only buy the blade, and you have to make your handle. So that's a con about this knife. You have to be able to make your handle yourself. But I haven't used this a lot because it's actually very difficult to use. I have to practice more to use it that way. And then there's this, a little draw knife, hand forged. I bought it in Denmark on the Viking market. I love it very much, and of course you can use it to take bark off a stick or some wood. As you can see, I'm using it here, and it's a very old school knife, and there's no handle on, only these, but it functions very nicely too. It's only a small one, so for larger locks and so on it's not useful, but for smaller sticks and so on, this is a good tool. And I just made a little sheet for it, so it protected, the blade is protected here. Yeah. And now, for these two, the last one. Of course, my little axe from Hultafors. It's a great axe when you are carving, because it's small, doesn't weigh much, and it's very, very sharp. So you can use this when you're beginning to make a kuxa, and other things, larger
things if you're going to make a bowl as such. Always nice to have a little hatchet or axe. You can cut a lot of material in a very short time, and if you're careful, this can be your best friend in the carving. And this tool is called a bowl edge. It's for when you are carving something bigger than a cook's, perhaps a bowl. You can use it for many other things. You can see here, it's rounded here. And as you can see in this little clip, one of the things you can use it for. This one I also bought on the Viking market last summer. And again, it's hand forged. And I've not used this a lot. This is also a tool I'm going to try to use more this year and be better in using it. Well, this is my tools, and again, these tools are for larger projects, and this is my big tool set for all kind of carving tasks. And this is my small tool set that I have always with me and I can use when I'm up on a hike and I like to carve a little spoon or spatula, perhaps a little cook's egg.
Skål. Thanks for joining me on this awesome day in Denmark. We haven't got any lockdowns yet, and well, I don't think we'll have the government has closed all schools and most works. Only hospitals and other important businesses are open here, so, and all the borders are are closed too. So I think, I hope they have control and that we can prevent that we are going to have a lockdown as they have in many other countries. And that would be very hard for me because then I wouldn't be able to come out here and enjoy myself and make videos for you. So, skål for that, and I hope it'll stay that way. In a moment, I'm going to make my fire out in my fire pit. Don't think I've done that this year. No, I used my wood box and my little Svea stove. I tried to make food out here when I was with my friend Johnny, but it began to rain and it was very dark and windy and so on. So we used the oven for that. So. This is the first time this year I'm making a fire in my fire pit, so Well, I'm looking forward to that, and then I'm going to make my tea, my blackberry root bark tea. And I'll explain why it's called that when I'm making it. Yeah, but I also have to take my jacket off, my anorak, because it's really hot out here. I think the temperature was about 11 degrees Celsius when I drove down here, and it's been even more warmer since then. So I have to take my anorak off and have my little tuvi cap from Grimfrost. Yeah, and I'm going to make my fire. You can see down here in my tinder pouch, there's a lot of all kind of tinder I can use, but it has been too small. So now I'll try this, see if I can ignite this with a fire steel. And there was something. Oops, a piece of flint. Yeah, and now it's very exciting, and this is what I have got out of that portion I harvested some weeks ago. As you can see here, I cut it up in small pieces, mainly the bark that was on these roots. These roots are almost, there's no bark on, it's a little bit here. I think, yeah, there's a bark on. And it's like a little notch, you have to peel them. And that's not very easy to do. I used an axe, some knives, a saw, and even a plier that I can that can cut branches. And finally, after some hours, I got a portion. I have the same amount back home, but not so much. What I'm going to do, I'm not going to use much. They say that's one teaspoon of this in one cup of water, boiling water, and let it stand for about 10 minutes. And that's why I'm going to use this one that is thermal, so it can keep the heat for a long time, because 10 minutes is a long time to have this standing without being cold. So approximately 1 teaspoon and fill it up with water. And this is how it looks. Of course the wood and the bark will be on the top of the surface, and somehow I'm going to filter that. I'm not quite sure how. And then I put the lid on and we'll wait about 10 minutes. And now it's been 10 minutes since I put it in, and most of the root are actually gone to the bottom, so it sinks a little bit. How's the color? A little bit brownish. Let me taste it. It's not bad at all. It's sweet in taste. It tastes a little bit like chamomile tea, I think it's called in English. Well, it's actually good. And this tea should be very healthy. It contains antioxidants and tannins. It is good for treating diarrhea, fluid retention, sore throat, diabetes, gout, pain and swelling, anti-inflammatory, prevent cancer and heart diseases. And there's no known side effects. So it's a very healthy drink, and I can definitely recommend you to try it. It tastes very good, very sweet, and because of the root bark is in large pieces, you don't get it in your mouth when you drink it like this. Or else you can filter it in something you have at home or bring with you. But again, blackberry root, the bark on the blackberry root, that's the best thing. And also the leaves, of course, are very well known as a nice cup of tea. But this one is something I can recommend you to try. Now it's time for my coffee. A little bit of salt, I can recommend that. Just let it cook for a minute or so, and then it's finished. Just have to rest for about 2 or 3 minutes. Well, folks, this is all for now. Thank you for watching Kimber Bushcraft. I hope you liked this little video and my series Bushcraft from A to Z in random order. Perhaps you learned a few things, new things, and can be motivated to begin carving yourself. It's a very nice thing to do and be able to, and my recommendation is you start with trying to carve a spoon. A kuxa is a much more difficult and a larger project, so start with a little spoon, and all you need is a little spoon knife, a little hook knife, and a little knife to do the other things. But before I go, I have to say thank you from my heart to all your new subscribers out there. I have reached the 40,000 subscribers, and I can't believe it. It's amazing, and I'm so proud. Yeah, I didn't thought that I should reach that milestone so quick. It was only December the 11th that I had 30,000, and now 10,000 more. It's amazing. Thank you again for watching Kimber Bushcraft and for staying aboard my little Viking longboat and my little friendly community. I seldom get feedback or comments that are cruel or negative. 99% are all positive and very kind, and I appreciate that very much. So thank you everybody out there, also my old subscribers that have been with me all from the beginning. I really appreciate that you are so faithful and has stuck on for so long time. Thank you very much. So, and again, thank you for watching Kimber Bushcraft. I really appreciate that, and I hope to see you again on the next one. And take especially care in these difficult times with the corona. Stay safe and keep your family safe. See you on the next one. Bye bye.